order. If you'd please rise and join us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Madam Clerk, could I have a roll call, please?
Alderman Bachelman.
Here.
Alderman Bowman.
Present.
Alderman Dickerson.
Here.
Alderman Long.
Here.
Alderman Milner.
Present.
Alderman Reese.
Present.
Alderman Stafford.
Here.
Alderman Turner.
Here.
And Mayor Hassig.
Here, and we do have a quorum. Good evening, everyone. Tonight, we do have a ceremonial matter. A few fine young ladies and gentlemen would join me up here, please. It's that time of year for FFA week. We have a proclamation. I'll read. Whereas FFA and agricultural education provide a strong foundation for the youth of America and the future of the food, fiber, and natural resource system, and whereas FFA promotes premier leadership, personal growth, and career success among its members, and whereas agricultural education and FFA ensure a steady supply of young professionals to meet the growing demands in the science, business, and technology of agriculture, and whereas the FFA motto, learning to do, doing to learn, earning to live, living to serve, give direction and purpose to these students who take an active role in succeeding in agricultural education, and whereas FFA promotes citizenship, volunteerism, patriotism, and cooperation. Now, therefore, on behalf of the Board of Aldermen and the City of Harrisville, I, Mayor Brian Hassig, do hereby designate the week of February 8th through the 25th, 2017, as FFA Week in Harrisonville.
Jason, do you want to get in there with them?
Right.
I'll take you, Richard.
I know you will.
Come on.
All right, we'll get a quick photo shoot here.
Scoot in if you all would there at the end.
Thank you all very, very much.
All right, thank you. I've known this one right here since it was about that tall. So.
Wait, you
see he's taller than you.
That's right. Yeah, yeah, he's taller than me. So, all right, well, thank you. Thank you.
Oh, that is.
That's it for our ceremonial matters. At this time, I'll open the floor to public participation. Anybody who has anything to bring before the board that is not on our already scheduled agenda, now is your time. Seeing no one, I'll close public participation and move on to the approval of the minutes. First, we have Board of Aldermen special meeting from February 6, 2017, 6 p.m. meeting.
Move to approve.
Come on, Marky.
Second.
Motion from Alderman Dickerson and a second from Alderman Milner. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Minutes are approved. Next, we have the minutes from the regular meeting of February 6, 2017.
Move to approve.
Second.
Motion from Alderman Milner, second from Alderman Dickerson. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Minutes are approved. Moving on to Council Bill 010. Before we have second reading, I have a suggestion on this. Do we want to do the second reading before my suggestion, or do we need to read it the second reading?
I think we go ahead and rehab the second reading, and then if you're going to amend it, or if there's further discussion, I think you have the discussion and then amend it if necessary.
Very well. Second reading then.
Council Bill 010, second reading, an ordinance amending Section 355.010, Schedule 2 of the Harrisonville Code of Ordinances regarding parking / no parking on Elm Street.
All right. Kind of looking this over, there's two parts to this. There's the parking between Halsey and Price Street on the north and south side, be the west part of Elm, and then there's the east, which is actually in front of the high school. After further discussion, looking at this, kind of talking to some people around the area, I think we need to split these two out into two separate pieces. The parking from Halsey to Price Street, I think, is pretty cut and clear. It, both sides, I think, what is early release time, Marcy?
Usually, like, well, for the high school, it would be 12:15, probably 12:10.
So 11 o'clock would cover an early release time for any of the schools, correct? If a start time of 11, meaning a no parking, if a start time at 11, there's no school getting out before 11 o'clock?
Not unless there would be an emergency situation.
Okay. So the suggestion I would have on that area is a parking 11 to 4, no parking either side of the road from Price Street to Halsey Street. I think there's some signs up there now. We have two different signs on the east side. There's one that says, I believe, 9 or 11 o'clock to 2 o'clock, and then there's another one that says the same thing only until 4 o'clock. So kind of want to get some clarification on what the actual parking is on either side up there now. I think the one side is already no parking. But I think we could definitely take care of the west side tonight. I think we need to have a little more discussion on the east side, but open to suggestions, comments. Yes?
Mr. Mayor, I just wanted to add as well, and I emailed Mr. Welch earlier, another good reason to split this up is that some of the other descriptions of parking are a little vague as to the parameters. For example, there's a reference to the Tricorp building. Are we going from the building or from the property line? If it's property line, which property line? And so it would seem to me that if targeting your most urgent issue that's definable clearly would be first and get it passed, and then we could have a second ordinance if it's necessary that has been clarified as to the parameters, and then address that separately, I think would be a good approach, just from a legal standpoint.
So I have a question then. John, on Elm, from, let's say, the high school down, even to the stoplight, is there parking on either side of that road right now? And if so, how far down does it go?
North side down, just past the school.
Yeah. On the north side?
On the north or the south side? I was going to drive up through there, and I couldn't remember.
There's no parking, which is the side that Ms. Lobachman was on. Mm-hmm. There's no parking from 7 until 2 on school days.
Now, there's a second sign up there. There's two signs up there now, and they have conflicting times. That's why I was questioning.
On the south side?
I think so, yeah.
I don't know the second sign.
So what about from Smith's house? Let's take from Smith's house and in front of the high school on east to the stoplight. What parking is there right now?
Right now, we've been watching some and when school gets out, but right now on the south side in front of high school, mm-hmm. all the way down to Galaxy right there, mm-hmm. there's no parking on the south side during school hours from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. That's where all the signs say. So that's. And the north side, there's the houses, and you have parking there on the north side. Up to the, what they're calling the Tricorp building, which is where the old Harrisonville family mm-hmm. medicine building. From that building up to the high school, there's no parking on the north side.
After that building?
At all. Yep. From that building west to Price, there's no parking on the north side of Elm at any time. And then the south side is only from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. during school.
And the suggestion for to change that is exactly what?
I would suggest no parking on both sides. But from the Tricorp building to the high school to Price Street, mm-hmm. no parking at all.
It's kind of a few residential in there, but, you know, I think people, you know, they should have parking in front of it.
I think the north side of the building should have no parking all the way to Price Street, or all the way to Grand Street.
And what timeframe?
All the time.
The north side would have it all the time.
Because, I mean, 2 o'clock doesn't even cover release.
Right, and the 2 o'clock time, I'm not saying I agree with the 2 o'clock time, it was...
I mean, right now, the north side, I think it's fine. You got no parking anytime from that building up to Price, so that puts from the high school on the north side. That's no parking all the time. Now, on the south side, there's currently no parking from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. during school. And there's suggestion no parking at all.
Yes.
All the way down to Mechanic?
All the way to Mechanic.
Yeah, okay. And I mean, really, why would anybody need to park on that? No, I mean, I'm just asking.
Because there's a lot of issues, or a lot of things at the school where there's not enough parking. And they park all down Elm, on my north property line, it's Merlin Smith. It's overflow parking on the things that happen nights and weekends.
But do you want it? That's the question.
Doesn't bother me either.
The show choir competition, that's a good example. I had said something about overflow parking at the Cass Career, and they had the buses parked for that event for all the different schools down at Cass Career. So there was very little parking available down there. So that's where they were lining the cars up for the show choir competition. I think it wasn't last weekend, the weekend before last. And because I asked, I was like, well, is there, you know, they suggested having overflow. And they said, no, that was full. And the parking lot was very full. So there was limited parking. I'm kind of surprised it didn't overflow back into some of the other side streets. So.
And what I'm basing my decision on both sides, is if you have parking on both sides, say we have a show choir or Rummage Sale Weekend, you have parking on both sides, I'm not sure you're going to get an ambulance or a fire truck in there very safely.
No, I don't see an issue with the north side being parking all the time, in front of the school, basically down to where it is now. And then, no matter where you are on that road, it should only be one side or the other, because it's, I agree with you, you get both sides, especially during Garage Sale Weekend, it's a little bit packed. So, Alderman Turner, did you have something other?
Well, also with the show choir, but if you've got a basketball tournament going on, a Russian practice, and then something in the PAC, you got two or three events going at the same time, you run out of parking. So people typically park on the south side of Elm, for that. If we block it all the time, when cars are going to park.
I think that's the time you want to park it, because it's a safety issue. It's dark out there. People are crossing the street. They're not parking. They're crossing at crosswalks. People are driving by and around these cars. I think that's a safety issue. I think that's why we want no parking there.
Well, I mean, this time it's adults with their kids and not just taking them to school. But if it's on one side,
in my opinion, having no parking on the south side and parking on the north, for the reasons you're saying, then people can walk right to their cars, they're not crossing the road, then it would be overflow parking for these special events at the school. I don't know that I care which way this goes, I just want to point out the issues one way or another. Mr. Hofer has some good ideas.
I see what you're saying, Brad. If you went parking on the north side, if you're trying to get to one side, then at least if you're picking up kids on their, getting on the passenger side of the vehicle, their doors up against the sidewalk and not up against the road, or something, right?
Yeah. Jump up for special events.
Well, it'd be after school hours. It wouldn't be during school hours. Right. I mean, I think everybody's mostly in favor of at least till 4 o'clock. Both sides would definitely be no parking. It's the after hours parking that is the question.
And I know that
there's events that go on, and they do, I mean, it is used frequently for overflow.
Where's that overflow going to go?
Well, that's why I say I think you need one side or the other. I mean, if the north side, I see your point. You're not crossing the road then.
Yeah.
You're just right there. I mean, there was maybe, what do you think, 8 to 10 cars at any given time Saturday?
On the south side, there's usually only that many.
Right, and that was for that event.
Oh, then?
Yeah.
They were parking all the way down past this house.
I didn't.
I don't know how many were there then. Could have been 25 maybe.
Your recommendation of having no parking on either side of the street is not solely your recommendation, correct?
No, we've discussed it with our Harrisonville Cares Coalition.
The Harrisonville Cares Coalition.
And staff.
And Mr. Patterson and...
Mr. Jacobs.
And Mr. Jacobs. And they're all concur that it's a safety issue, it's not a convenience issue. And I believe that these are the specialists. I'm not an engineer. Eric is an engineer. I believe if they think that this is what we need to prevent the loss of another life of a student in our city, then I think we need to step back and look at it from a safety perspective and not just a convenience perspective.
Is the school involved in that group?
Yes.
Do they see any issue with the parking if we go, for events and things?
No, they didn't say anything. We have the high school principal involved, and we have the assistant superintendent. They've attended every meeting.
Oh, well. Whenever we was all standing out there, they held back. When we was all standing out there, they held back the high school kids to let the school buses out. And then when the high school kids come out, we obviously seen they were on the gas. And you said yourself that...
That was only one day, and after that, they didn't do it that way anymore.
Yeah.
I don't know what changed, but it's not being done that way now.
Well, that's why I was asking if
we were out,
because we talked about it, and you said that...
Well,
Brad said that it had never been done that way.
While we were out there that day, I did speak with the principal at the high school, and I told him that was my concern. And we've also made up a stop sign that we would like to put in the crosswalk just that day. And it is red. Mr. Jacobs got in touch with me this afternoon and said that's ready to go when you want to go.
Yeah, that definitely would be helpful, because I think not having the parking, unfortunately, some people that aren't, they're the wittiest, like Brad said, when the cars are there, they were almost forced to slow down. Now it's wide open and they don't necessarily slow down, but the stop sign will help keep
the speed down.
Yeah,
that's the purpose.
Yeah, exactly.
And it'll be right there in the crosswalk.
Right.
Well, same thing they do at Washington.
It kind of draws the attention to it for the kids. They see the sign, oh yeah, I should go down. You'd hope they'd go down, but...
When we were observing that day, I was out there, and the only thing I think you need to do is you need to have an officer out there at 3 o'clock to help. The kids were crossing across the street, above the crosswalk, over into Smith's yard. There must have been, I don't know how many, 20 kids running through that yard. And they need to be confined to the crosswalk and shown how to walk on the side.
There's no way you're going to get that done.
Wouldn't you?
Hey.
Good deal.
Hey.
Yep, you were next.
Hey, me and Brad was watching today, and everybody used the crosswalk. Nobody cut across the middle. Cars stopped, and they went through. No one parked out front. Some kids went out, then they stopped, and buses went out, and the rest of the kids went out. Everyone was driving fine, we weren't speeding. Everyone went down to the crosswalk, crossed over, and no one cut through the yards. I mean, today was a perfect day.
It was very orderly outside of that. Well, I would have a cop out there.
We don't have enough. We have one officer.
What you did, getting the cars off of Elm, I mean, that helped tremendous, for the drivers coming over the hill, being aware, and kids, seeing the cars coming and everything. I mean, just getting them off of Elm really helped, control the whole situation. And also, we haven't had the cars parked on the south side either. And unless you keep that open, then that really, along the flow, all that we need to really concentrate on is no parking on the times to make sure Elm stays open for the buses and the cars. And
the only time you have parking there is when there's an event after hours.
Day.
Or garage sales occasionally, but usually I don't ever see any cars parked on there when it's not an event going on, so it's...
They were parking there to pick up after school.
Right, no, I'm talking about after school. No, I agree with you. I knew they were parking there for that. They've been doing that for years. So.
Yeah, last Thursday, we were watching them, and a girl hurry up and got out of the parking lot and park right in front of us, right in front of his house on the side of the road. And then buses were going, and her friend come out and crossed the road and jumped in. Well, then your police officer stopped him down there at the crosswalk and said something to him. Yeah, and then they drove on. So, as and they got warned not to do that.
Brian?
Yeah.
From what we saw today, based on school hours, I don't think there can be any improvement. It worked good. Mm-hmm. I mean, nobody cut across. Everybody used the crosswalks. Visually, what we could see, nobody was speeding. Mm-hmm. The traffic coming out of the parking lot, some cars left before the buses. They stopped them, the buses came out, and then the rest came out. It wasn't a madhouse. Everything was good. Mm-hmm. The only thing that I would recommend, there again, is that stop sign down there.
If the no parking time's till 2, what about if we put it to 4 in that section as well? I mean, that takes care of the school hours.
That would take care of the school hours. But maybe we ought to, I don't know how to do this, but as far as the after hours, parking there on the after school events, mm-hmm. we might discuss that, like maybe back at committee level or something.
Well, right now, we currently have no parking on the north side at all. Mm-hmm. And then we have parking on the south side, but you're concerned about kids crossing after the events and whatnot. What if we were to flip that? No parking ever on the south side, all the way to Mechanic. And then on the north side, from the Tribe Building up to Price, no parking 11 to 4, but otherwise, for events, you can park on the north side. That way you're at the school, and you walk through the schoolyard and get in the car and not crossing the road. That would still take care of the overflow parking, and kids are not crossing the road.
I think that'd be the best solution, but I don't know all the details.
Okay.
My concern with that would be starting at 11, you'd have people stopping and dropping their kids off rather than go through the drop-off.
Oh, okay. Well, if we do the north side, because this is in front of school, you could just say 7 a.m. to 4 p.m.
Or even 7. Yeah. I mean, there's no houses there. Yeah. You're not like you're putting somebody out having to go move their car at 6 o'clock in the morning and then put it back if they park there. There's not a residential, so that issue is, that's a non-issue in that area, so.
Because it is the school only, go ahead and do the 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. That way, parents ain't stopping, parking, drop the kids off, and up on the back. Because currently, every time we go out there, there is a car on the other side of Elm, between Price and Holiday, that parks, mm-hmm. and they create a big traffic jam because the buses are trying to turn, cars are coming down, and it just, I mean, it's crazy. There ain't any more rest there if the cars are parking, because then we'll wait around.
Well, today I think we can address the from Price West and get that part done. From Price East, we need more discussion other than this meeting.
If I can say one thing, I've talked to several of the people, the high school teachers and some of the directors that are over there, and their thought is, or something for you all to think about is, whatever you choose to do on either side, west or east, do the same times at the same, so that there is no confusion as to, during these times of the day, these are the lots.
Yeah.
This is the way it is. Don't split it up on the west side because it's going to inconvenience people who have to park there and have to go to work and do all that. Make it all the same so that there is no confusion in the kids' minds or the parents' minds. At these kinds of days, this is the way it's going to be. That was something they asked for you all to please consider.
Yeah, well, see, that's where, at first, I was just thinking 11 to 4 would be a good time for both sides.
But 11 isn't going to help.
Well, maybe for the early release, but now in the mornings, he brought up, if we switch it, it's going to be a 7.
So they think...
You do it both sides.
They think that west of Price Street would be a confusion? I mean,
they just think that if you're going to change the way the flow is, as of right now, if you're going to change anything, make it all the same hours.
The only thing is with that west side, I mean, you don't see, in the morning, you see zero issue in the morning. There's nobody parking there, nobody dropping off there. They kind of trickle in. It's not, you know, because not everybody gets to school at exactly the same time. It's on the way home. There's the people stopping to pick kids up that maybe rode the bus in the morning, whatever, and they're parking on that north side, waiting as they come around the sidewalk, they come out now across the crosswalk, and then they pick them right there. Well, it's right where you come around the corner, so everybody has to swing wide, and that's where the bottleneck is. But as far as in the mornings, you know, the kids don't have a reason to be parking there, or I don't know what confusion it could possibly cause. So.
I'm just giving you the input that they asked me to present.
So, just one thing. I've kicked this around a little bit. I know Brad and I have talked about it, and honestly, I think Brad's got an idea that I liked, and we kind of were talking about the other day. But as we kick around some more and listen to the chief talk, we may be somewhat kicking a dead horse that we don't have to, because based upon how it's proposed now, the only people that that's really an inconvenience is when the school has an event and we have overflow issues. Well, if the school is okay with it, why are we trying to overanalyze it? We've talked to the people that it's going to affect, so they seem to be okay. I don't know maybe know why we put more thought into it. Yeah, I know, but the school said they don't care.
Well, no, we're talking about from Price to Halsey.
Based upon the current verbiage, they're okay with it. Why do we feel the need to change it? I mean, because that's truly who it affects. I mean, I think the only parking there is truly school event stuff. I mean, I don't know anybody that just parks there.
Well, when they were dropping, like he said, when they picked up the kids, that was what they were trying to eliminate, correct. And that was the driving force behind that piece of it. The other was the fact that there's cars parked at school getting out in the afternoon. That's a busy road.
Right. I would completely agree. I mean, it's a safety issue. But if that committee, that group has talked about it and thinks this is the best way, and the real people that it affects is the school for their events, and they seem to think it's a good idea. I mean, because like you said, it's not like there's a whole bunch of residential there that's affecting parking for everybody. I mean, it's
Yeah, I was just going to comment. You've got four items under Section 3 of the ordinance. Two of them need further definition. The first and third are probably sufficiently defined. You could either put a time or just say no parking on those, but the second and third need further definition before we move forward. So I would recommend that either you wait further or go ahead and approve what you want related to the first and third items tonight, and then have a new ordinance to deal with the others after we further define the sections.
So that would be the no parking, no standing anytime on the south of Elm Street between Price Street and Mechanic Street, we weren't putting a designated time. No parking anytime on the south side of Elm Street, from the Price to Halsey Street. Actually, I think it was the north side we were going to allow parking because it had a curb. Is that right?
Yeah. It's got somewhat of a curb.
Yeah, it's at least something there more than.
And that's a very narrow street. I drove that today, and that's just very, very narrow, especially if somebody's parked out there.
So it'd be no parking. We're suggesting no parking all the time on the south side, and a timed parking on the north side for that. That's the west section.
Well, not tonight. Both of these deal with the south side.
Well,
sections.
Well, this is saying. Oh, okay. I see. Both are on the south. Okay, I apologize.
Right. One's from Halsey to Price. Okay, the other Price to Mechanic.
Either section has a.
So you could either say no parking or specify a time.
What would be the issue with this piece?
Well, because Elm Street. I mean, you could do this, but understand that affects.
Oh, there's no. It doesn't say.
It doesn't say where it ends or starts.
Okay, so it doesn't.
It's
say.
Just the entire Elm Street that exists in the city of Harrisonville, the way that works.
Okay.
So that goes go out and as far as it goes. And so now, if that's what your intent is, then that's definitive. But I assume that wasn't the intent. Because as I look on the Google Maps, Elm Street goes quite a ways to the east, and I don't think that was the intent of what you're trying
to address. So both
Elm Street crosses the highway?
Yes.
Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Yeah.
So
there isn't parking along there anyway.
Well, I'm just saying that the way this is defined.
On that particular road, it's not.
It's definitive if you want all of Elm Street not to have parking. But if, the idea is to target the area by the school, then this is not definitive to that purpose.
So correct me if I'm thinking wrong, but if when, once you cross Mechanic and what we call Orient Cemetery Road, which I guess is technically considered Elm still.
It's still Elm.
But there's never been parking along there, right?
Well, I don't know about never, there is now.
There is no parking now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think it was to Mechanic Street with where we were looking at this.
Right, but I mean, this truly, in a sense, doesn't affect that, does it?
No. So no parking, saying.
Because it's already no parking.
From Price to Mechanic.
Yeah, see, I don't know what that is. I'm just saying that it's not very well defined here, and I don't, when I looked at the map, Elm was quite long, and I didn't know if that's what you really intended.
I think that truly would be what we would intend.
Yeah, well, it says from Price Street east to Mechanic Street, which is.
Right, that's the anytime on the south side.
The other's the north side. The last item is the north side. Well, if that's what you intend, you can pass that item too, but.
Well, yeah, but it just doesn't say where at on Elm Street.
Right.
That's my point. Defined in a moment.
Right.
The last part, no parking on north side of Elm Street from 7 to 4 when school's in session, from Price to Hall.
So then you're.
That's what needs to be added.
So if we add that though, are you then telling people that on the east side of Mechanic, they can park there on the north side? Is that what that's going to end up saying?
No, not unless you're changing that item. So if that's already no parking, whatever is already defined for that section of the road would not change.
Yeah.
This would just define a different section.
Yeah. See right here, it already says there's no parking or standing, or no parking anytime on the north side of Elm from Tricor Building, intersection of Elm and Price. That's already no parking. It just, the other part of Elm is what they're talking about, it's not defined from Price to Halsey.
Well, with respect to the one that references the Tricor Building.
Right, it needs to be.
It needs to be better defined as either one of the property lines or a specific point. You can't just say the building.
As an address.
No, not even that. You'd have to specifically say one property line.
Could be like the east side of that property.
So now we've had second reading, if we need to.
You could amend to pass what you want tonight and then come back, or you could hold it again and get the clarification you want and then pass it next time.
Can we amend it to do it from Price West and get that done tonight?
Sure.
Well, I'd make that motion.
Okay, so you would want to amend from Halsey or Price Street to Halsey Street on Elm.
On which, north or south? Both.
No parking north or south side all the time.
Whatever this board agrees to.
7 to 4.
I'm okay with any of it.
Yeah. 7 to 4. Right now, as it is.
I think there's not room for parking on both sides.
And
so one side is going to have no parking all the time.
Right.
Well, the south side will be no parking all the time.
The south side will be parking all the time, and then the north side again, that's where there's the residents. That's where I suggested 11 o'clock instead of a 7 o'clock, so if somebody's parked there in the morning, they don't have to get up at 7 o'clock in the morning and move their car. But
personally, I'd make that whole area, because I think that area is a disaster. I'd make that no parking on both sides all the time, if it was me. I don't know who, there's what, 3 houses in there, I don't know if we've seen anything to them, how that affects them.
5 houses.
If they're using the street, but I think that, personally, I feel like that small section of street we're talking about, way worse than that whole section in front of the high school.
Mm-hmm. Yes, that is the problem.
I agree.
I'm not saying there's anything to be done with the section in front of the high school, but that short section of road right there is a freaking nightmare.
Yeah.
And it's a nightmare from all directions. If you're coming off Halsey onto there, if you're coming from Price to there, I think it's terrible all the time. Because if you get, that section is so short, if somebody's parked out on the street out there, from either one of those turns, you're never in the lane if anybody's parked on it. You're always in the opposite lane trying to get around.
Mm-hmm. When did you suggest, Mr. Hofer?
I didn't do times, I said no parking.
It would be 11 or 7, they're suggesting 7.
From all due to price.
You said.
No, I don't think it should be any time, because people, they got enough room for two cars in the driveway, they're gonna have any access parking.
Chief, I don't give a vote. Thanks, though.
Chief.
Eric's getting warm, too.
Original was no parking both sides?
I believe that was.
All the time?
Yeah, I believe that was.
Elm and all of them.
And I sent letters to all the residents.
Right.
And told them we were having a meeting if they wanted to come discuss it, and I never heard from anybody.
I talked to one guy, he said he didn't care what we did, but he's got parking around the back of his house.
You gotta protect the kids.
Mm-hmm.
Well, then, we can say, no parking.
So is that what the board wants to do, no parking both sides?
That's fine.
You're making the motion for the amendment.
Okay, so six of the aldermen have said, both sides. Okay, let's make it both sides.
All the time, or school hours?
All the time.
All the time.
So, Mr. Alderman Bachman, so I understand, so we make sure we get the ordinance correct, we're basically limiting section three to just no parking at any time on the north or south side of Elm Street from Price Street to Alden.
Yes.
Yep.
So the other two sections are out, and you can come back later and deal with them if you decide.
Yes.
Made the motion?
I made it.
Second motion.
Well, we'll read it here. I got a motion from Alderman Bachman to amend the ordinance to reflect no parking anytime north-south side of Elm Street from Price Street to Halsey. Who seconded it?
I did.
Alderman Turner seconded it. Discussion before.
He just told me.
Okay, so you got what you need.
Yeah.
Okay, so we need to vote on the amendment now.
Discussion, you said you talked to all the people that live there and they're.
One.
One.
The chief sent letters.
He talked to one.
Yeah.
Is no one's here about this?
Nope.
No, but I live up there and I turn out and you can't see. I don't think there should be parking right there. You can't. If someone was parked there, you.
Let Sean a bone, too.
All right.
Sorry.
So we need a roll call for the amendment.
Maybe they're not here because.
Okay, unless there's further discussion, we'll need a roll call for the amendment.
All right. Alderman Milner?
Aye.
Alderman Bowman?
Aye.
Alderman Long?
Aye.
Alderman Turner?
Aye.
Alderman Bachman?
Aye.
Alderman Dickerson?
Aye.
Alderman Stafford?
Aye.
And Alderman Reese?
Aye.
All right, so we need a second reading as amended.
Council Bill number 010, second reading as amended, an ordinance amending sections 355.010, Schedule 2 of the Harrisonville Code of Ordinances regarding parking/no parking on Elm Street.
All right, roll call again, please.
Alderman Dickerson?
Aye.
Alderman Stafford?
Aye.
Alderman Reese?
Aye.
Alderman Long?
Aye.
Alderman Bowman?
Aye.
Alderman Milner?
Aye.
Alderman Turner?
Aye.
Alderman Bachman?
Aye.
Okay, and Council Bill 010 becomes Ordinance 03399.
Brian?
Yes.
I'd like to ask Mr. Hofer a question.
Okay.
I think I heard you say in the past, if somebody lives on a road where there's no parking and they wanted to do a garage sale, that you could then put like sacks over no parking and give them permission temporary, like on a weekend or that type of thing?
We have done things like that. The one that comes to mind most is Casco, when they have a special event out there so that they can park on the plaza.
Okay.
We covered up.
So we can make some exceptions if they came up and.
Well,
I mean,
we have in the past.
Right, okay.
I don't know that we've ever done a residential, but.
Well, I mean, I think a couple of houses normally typically have garage sales, they're citywide, and now there's no parking on both sides of the street, people's going to be parking there anyway to go to garage sale.
Yep.
I mean, would it be fine?
Yeah.
But I mean, if the sides were there, would it be fine for going to garage sale?
Would they be ticketed, no parking ticket?
Yeah.
I'm not going to say it's never going to happen, but I can't remember the last time we gave a parking.
I think they're probably kind of lenient on that weekend if it's not.
I mean, I just.
Off your discretion.
Well, they're too busy doing other things.
things.
All right, well, let's quit beating the horse there. We'll bring the other back in another meeting. So we're moving on. Item B, there's some language issues, so we're going to pull that tonight and bring it back at the next meeting. Council Bill 013.
First reading, Council Bill 013, a resolution, resolutions authorizing the city administrator to execute an agreement with Max Ford for the purchase of two 2017 police interceptor SUVs at a price not to exceed $28,742.28 each for a total expenditure not to exceed $57,486.56.
What'd you run off for?
Well, I thought that there was...
It's your night.
I thought there was an item B on there.
Oh.
It must be good.
Sorry.
I backed off.
You didn't
sorry.
Get the memo, did you?
Well, I'm back, and this is an agenda item. It's the purchase of two 2017 police SUVs for the police department, replacing two vehicles that would go out of service. We took state bid and compared it to a local price through Max Ford. Max Ford came in a little bit cheaper, and we are recommending the purchase of these two vehicles for $57,044.56 from Max Ford, and the remainder of the balance will go to the equipment needed for those vehicles. Entertain any questions?
Any questions for the chief? Entertain a motion to approve.
Motion to approve.
Second.
A motion from Alderman Milner, and I have a second from Alderman Turner. Any discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed?
Nay.
And Council Bill 013 becomes Resolution R005. Council Bill 014.
Council Bill 014, first reading, an ordinance of the Board of Aldermen, Missouri, to amend Article 4, Section 420.150 of the Harrisonville Code of Ordinances.
Mr. Martin, good evening.
Good evening, Mr. Mayor, members of the board. One of the purposes of the flood insurance program, besides providing insurance opportunities to flood-prone homes, is to provide guidance to redevelopment and new development. In December of 2012, the city of Harrisonville adopted new floodplain maps and flood ordinances as required by FEMA to maintain our participation in this national flood insurance program. Periodically, FEMA and the state of Missouri will update their requirements for municipalities to regulate their floodplains. Now FEMA has an amendment to our ordinance intended to protect homeowners from overinvesting in flood-prone properties beyond the limits insurance will cover without bringing these residential structures into compliance. This modification is an amendment to the Municipal Code of Ordinance Section 420.150, General Standards with the additional paragraph, Cumulative Improvement Section, Subsection G. A structure may be improved, remodeled, or enlarged without conforming to current requirements for elevation so long as the cumulative value of all work done within the last 5 calendar years does not exceed 50% of the structure's current market value. If the cumulative value of the improvements exceed 50% of the structure's current market value, the structure must be brought into compliance with Article 4, Section B1, which requires elevation of residential structures to or above base flood elevation or to elevation flood proofing of non-residential residential structures to or above the base flood elevation. This has been to the Public Works Committee. Are there any questions?
And my understanding is when it comes to FEMA, you don't bark, you just say, yes.
Communities all over the country are having to comply with this,
yes.
Just to stay in the program.
And you definitely want to stay in the program.
It's just a normal update.
Yes. Yeah. It's just updating the current ordinance. Well, if there's no questions, I would entertain a motion to move Council Bill 014 to the second reading. Got a motion from Alderman Turner.
Second.
Second from Alderman Dickerson. Any discussion? Any roll call, please?
Alderman Long?
Aye.
Alderman Reese?
Aye.
Alderman Bockelman?
Aye.
Alderman Dickerson?
Aye.
Alderman Turner?
Aye.
Alderman Milner?
Aye.
Alderman Bowman?
Aye.
Alderman Stafford?
Aye.
Second reading, please.
Second reading, Council Bill 014, an ordinance of the Board of Aldermen of Harrisonville, Missouri, to amend Article 4, Section 420.150 of the Harrisonville Code of Ordinances.
Roll call again, please.
Alderman Dickerson.
Aye.
Alderman Stafford.
Aye.
Alderman Reese.
Aye.
Alderman Long.
Aye.
Alderman Bowman.
Aye.
Alderman Milner.
Aye.
Alderman Turner.
Aye.
Alderman Bachelman.
Aye.
And Council Bill 014 becomes Ordinance 03400. That concludes the agenda items. We'll move on to Alderman Committee Reports. Alderman Bowman.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have a couple of things tonight. At our last meeting, I talked about the Valentine's event that the Chamber held for Keystone Community, and I wanted just to report back to you that that was a huge success. We had a great night on the historic square, and I see Obie in the room. I want to thank you again, Obie, for what the Chamber did in hosting that event. Then on this past Saturday, I had the opportunity to attend the Valentine's dinner and dance for the disabled community in Harrisonville. We fed spaghetti to about 100 of those folks and their friends and family members, and they enjoyed the dance, and that was a great time. I want to remind you all of the poker tournament event this Saturday evening at Trade Fair to benefit Sailor Johnson and the kids that play softball with her. David, what time does that start? Is it 3 o'clock?
Chili is from 3 to 7. The actual poker event's at 6.
Okay. And I know it's a great cause to continue to raise funds for Sailor Johnson's family, and I think they also want to share some of that with kids that play softball on the team that she played on who need some help purchasing softball equipment. So turn out. It's a great event. Be a fun time and good cause. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you. Alderman Bachelman.
Nothing.
Alderman Reese.
Nothing to say.
Alderman Milner.
I just need to thank our EMS people. I don't know who was here tonight, but unfortunately we had to use an ambulance again to transport down to St. Louis on the Plaza, and they were amazing as always. And we so appreciate the kindness that they showed and took good care of our passengers. So I wanted just to thank them and give them a shout out because I don't think they get the recognition they deserve.
I agree. I have been in there and they do a good job. Is that it?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Alderman Dickerson.
I'd like to make a request that we get the financial status on where we're at with the K-9, how much money's been raised, who's raised it, what the status is, how close we are to getting it. And I'd like to know, I'd like that information furnished to the board.
You got that, John?
You don't have to do it now. You can.
I pretty much have it. We are sitting at $27,600. I think $52.04. We've raised it through different events throughout the community. A golf tournament was a big one. Obie's had a couple events at his location with a car wash and a dog wash. But we've raised that money, and we're going for $35. It's going to be $10,000 alone just to outfit the car, not including the vehicle. But right now we're so short staffed we can't send anybody to training even if we had the dog. So
is the $24,000 including the $10,000 that the board gave you to
it is not.
The dog?
It is not. If we can't send anybody now anyway, so if we can try and raise that money and save the board's money to do it with something else, we're gonna try and do that. But right now we're short staffed and couldn't afford to have anybody off shift. Does that answer your question?
Yeah.
Anything else? Anything else, Alderman
Dickerson? Oh, no. I'll talk to you, John.
Alderman Long.
Did Hope leave? Did you say that we don't have a car for it now?
Oh, we do have a car.
Okay.
Last year when we wrecked the car, we kind of swapped it out.
Right, I remember.
But that has arrived. It's here.
Okay.
It showed up here a couple weeks ago. We're just ready. Everything's ready to go. We just got to raise that.
Okay, I thought that's what you said.
But right now we're short-staffed out on the street and we can't send anybody.
I understand.
But the car is here.
That's what I thought you said.
Sorry, I should have said that.
No, I remember you saying that you were swapping them out a few months ago or whatever, but I was just making sure. I'm good.
Alderman Kerr? Alderman Staff?
Thanks for arresting some people today, Chief. With any luck, the judge won't bond them out on the signature this time.
Actually, two of them are right here.
Good job, guys.
Mr. Welch?
I hope so.
Okay, just a couple of things. You saw the departmental review, staffing, or again, we've got ads in the paper. Our new building official starts next week. We've received about 15 to 20 applications for the city clerk's job. We're advertising for a building inspector. Jim Clark has taken over the codes departments. We're doing both economic development and the codes. He's doing a good job. So I'm glad to have that part going. We still got some staffing changes to take care of and keep moving forward. On the update report, I'm going to probably end up doing a piece of paper because there always seems to be something last minute that I think of that doesn't get in the report from Thursday. So just to draw your attention to a couple of things. One is item one. We had a meeting for downtown about the market, saying they needed some electric. We've been trying to figure out a way to get electric down there. One of the ways that we've kind of come up with is there is a clock that is stuck at 10 till 4 and probably isn't going to be changed because the parts are expensive and they break pretty easily. So one of the thoughts we've had is to pull that clock and put in 120 out, 120 electric that we can then use on Main Street for those groups that are down there. So we'll take this to the Historic Preservation Committee, but I'm just kind of gauging what the board thinks on something like that. Because it doesn't seem to provide a function at this point, and we can make that work and provide something. So if we have the farmer's market down there, the trunk in the trunk, something like that, or other activities down there, we'd have some electric, at least on one corner or one side of the street. The only other electric that's available is inside on the courthouse. And I'm not sure they want us to tap into that. Item two, I met the Love the Square group. We'll keep going to that meeting. Chris Deal was there as well. They're really, really excited to try to get some things going downtown, and I think we can help them, and we'll help them as best we can. So I've got some ideas. I'll be bringing those to you in the future. And item five, we'll be bringing a job description. We want to move April Clark over to the Public Works. We had talked about this. But we need to then replace her with someone, and we don't have a job description for the job that I want to create. It's kind of a combination. We'll put somebody else up front. They'll be answering phones, doing the building department work, kind of filling in what April's doing, but also doing some extra work. And having three people up front, I think would be better for customer service. So we have to create the job description so that we can hire the person. So once we get that done, we can advertise, then we'll make some staffing changes. We're waiting at this point anyway to create an office for her to move over to Public Works at this point anyway. So we can't move her, and she'll need to be around a little bit to teach the other person some of her job duties because they are pretty specific. So that's all I've got unless you have any questions.
I have a question for you, Mr. Welch. Would you tell us, and there's been a lot of discussion among the board about permits and inspections, and I know you have someone coming that's joining us at the end of the month. Who's doing inspections and codes right now for us? Are we utilizing the services of IBTS for that or not?
We're using them for the senior living project that's north of the community center. Danny Powell and myself are doing inspections at other areas in town.
And Danny Powell has been hired as an independent contractor?
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah, he does it 2 days a week, 8 hours a day. Mm-hmm. And so far, we've been able to cover what we need to. We haven't been able to. Some people can wait a couple of days. If not, then I'll go out and take a look at the end and do the inspection. But,
good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
All right. That's it. Very good. Had the pleasure of attending the MML's Missouri Municipal League's Legislative Conference. Good news is there's not really anything targeting the cities right now. They're with the swing in majority over to Republican side, they're going out of the gates at what they want to do, and they've kind of left the cities alone, which is nice. I'm sure as they get settled in, they'll refocus on, when they get their agenda items taken care of, they'll refocus on, okay, we're bored, we need something to do. We did meet with our representatives from this area. They were very receptive to things. Of course, they always are. We hope that they'll take some actions on some of the items brought up from the cities of Cass County. But all in all, it was a good conference. Like I said, nothing really severe coming down the pike this year. I'm sure some have noticed up on the square, the Cooks are hoping to be open about March 1st with the new coffee shop, so that's good news. Dale Williamson hopes in the next few weeks to get the tattoo parlor opened up. I went by there and took a look. It's decorated very, very interesting. I think it's going to be a neat place. I know he's excited, so that's another business open. And then, I don't know if anybody's noticed down the street here, the old Vans Flyer building, they've been working on that. It's my understanding that the ladies that own the clothing store where David Atkinson's has his building, where Guardgate Floral, they're next door, they actually bought that building and they're renovating it, so don't have any kind of estimate on when they're supposed to be done, but there'll be another building opened up. And then, of course, the church that had bought the Runnenberger building ended up buying the bank and is making that into their community center. So lots going on up there. I think as the warmer weather gets here, we're going to have more foot traffic up there. Hopefully drive some more of the events, kind of like Happy talked about, the Love the Square. Maybe we'll just keep building and building on that. So that's all good news. I want to just kind of give everybody a heads up. You do need to be careful. There have been some break-ins reported. My best suggestion is as much light as you can pour on your areas of your house. You know, no telling what causes these. I mean, there's probably a variety of reasons, but we are working on it. We are looking at it, but it's not an easy thing to catch. I think we could have 100 officers driving around. We wouldn't necessarily catch somebody doing something. So just kind of heads up that there are some people who are not doing good things, but we're working on trying to cut down on that. And that's really all I have this evening. We do not have executive session tonight, so.
Make a motion to adjourn.
There's a surprise. I have a motion from Alderman Dickerson and a second from Alderman Long to adjourn. All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? We are adjourned.